Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I will show you how to create a full backup of your Windows 11 system on an external drive, which includes all the default folders with your data on it. I will also show you how to restore your system from this backed up image without any third-party software. My name is Mazhar, and at Right Solution, I create a tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's get to this video. Come down here to the search bar here and type here control panel. And you can see that control panel app had come up on the top here. So just click on to launch this app and let's maximize it. And if your screen looks different than mine, so here in the top, you can see there's a view by. So just click on this arrow and select by category and your page will be look just like mine here. So now after selecting this category, so just come on the top here and see system and security. So just click on it. And in this window here, you can just see there are a lot of options here. So just go down and find the option which says backup and restore. And also in the brackets, you will see Windows 7 mentioned there too. So click on this to launch the app. And in this next window here, you can see there are two options here on the left side. So just click the first one on the top, which says create a system image. This will open up a dialog box here, which will prompt you to choose where you want to save this backup image. So you've got the options. You can save this to hard disk, maybe USB drive. You can just write it on DVDs, and you can also save it to on a network location. So we will select the hard disk, which is actually a USB drive. You can choose your own selection. And when you decide it, then click on next here. This will bring up this new dialog box here. And in this dialog box, you can see on the top, it says backup location, which is drive E. And I have connected USB with this. And in the second box, you can see that there's a drive C. And there are two other drives which are tagged along with this. The one is a system reserved, and the second one is a system recovery environment. So these all three portions will be backed up with this image. So click on start backup. And this will start collecting the information about your Windows backup, and it is preparing the backup. And you will see sometime if you have less space on your USB drive, so it might will give you the dialog box, which will say the label and insert the blank media, which is bigger than 1 GB. So if you have a bigger USB, you know that. So just click on OK and it will continue. And this backup could take a long time, depends on the Windows and the data of what you have on your drive C. So I will fast forward this and we'll come back when the data is almost copied on the image. So our image is almost done here. So you can see that after completing this copying of the image on the USB, it gives you the option that if you want to create a system repair disk, if you want to, you can do it, but I will click on no. So you can just go to the next dialog box here and just click on close. So your backup image is completely ready now. We can close this window also. And in the next part two, I will show you how to restore this. But before we start the restoring process, so let us do some changes here so we can just witness if our restore bring back the files which we already have on it. So let's create a new file here. Right click on the desktop and select new and select a text document. And just name it. This is a text file. And now let's delete some files here. So let's delete this Microsoft Edge shortcut here. And also we can delete this second file here, exported app HTML. So now let's also empty the recycle bin too. So yes. And now come down to the search bar here and type here recovery options. And you can see that this app had come up here. So just click on this app to launch this system settings recovery options. And now from here, if you can see that there is a advanced startup option here. And on the right side, you can see there's a button which says restart now. So just click on it. And now it also tells you the information about it. So just click on restart now. And now your Windows will be restarting. So it will take a little, it will restart a little slow. So I will just fast forward it slightly faster than the regular speed. So here we are in the maintenance menu here. So just click on the troubleshoot option here. And from here, you can just click on advanced options. And in here, you can see there is option system image recovery. So just click on it. And this is the place where it already had loaded the last image what we created here. But if you have more than one image, so just you can just click on the select system image here and click on next, and it will load the pages here, the images which are more than one. So mine is only one. So we'll just click back and go back to the same location and select the recommended one. Now click on next here. So it is also giving you information if you want to install something optional. But click next, and here you can see it has given you all the information about the image, the date and time of the image, and the computer name, whatever the computer it was, and then the drive to restore. So when you are satisfied that you want to do it, so click on finished. So it will give you another warning and will tell you that all the data will be replaced. So just click yes on it. And now this will start restoring the image from your USB drive. So this will take a longer time, depends on the data, how much has been copied on the image, and depending on the system size as well. So I will fast forward it, and we will see when the image is nearly completed. So image restore point is almost completed. If you just click restart now, it will restart now. Otherwise, it will take about a minute to restart itself. But let's click restart now. So now our system will restart. It will take a little while, so I'm just forwarding it again with the faster speed. So here you can see the login window has come up. So just let's enter the password. It's the same password that you have on the previous image when you created. So let's see, it is loading Windows. And here we are. And now you can also see that these two files which we actually deleted earlier, these files are back. And now you possibly know all the documents are back with you. And if you notice that the file, the test text file which we created, it is not there. So it is not there because that was created after we had created the image, and this restore image does not have that file. Okay guys, so that's all for this video. If you think this video given you some help, please give it a thumbs up, and I will see you with next video, and you have a wonderful day.